Hey, watch this.
You've probably heard that the Swiss have, by a referendum, decided against further immigration. That's not so. The Swiss have merely directed their government to limit immigration, to have a policy setting out the requirements that the country has in relation to immigration, the criteria, and the number which should come in each year. The Swiss are very liberal about immigration. 1 in 4 people in Switzerland are immigrants, and they're not concerned by that. What they are concerned about, and what the Australian people were concerned about, is the outsourcing of immigration to other authorities. In Australia, it was said to be the outsourcing to the people smugglers. In Switzerland, it was said to be the outsourcing of immigration policy to the bureaucrats and to the politicians in Brussels. And under the existing free movement of people in Europe, any one of the 500 million citizens and their dependents of the European Union could move into Switzerland. The European Union is expanding, it's moving towards the Bosphorus. And there is a potential candidate down there, Turkey, with another 76 million citizens possibly coming into Europe. Switzerland has just said, have reasonable controls. And that is what is going to happen in Switzerland, notwithstanding the screams of anguish by some European politicians. The Swiss referendum is a marvelous example in democracy. At the same time, they adopted a referendum, or rather they rejected a proposal that abortion be taken off the national health in Switzerland. It's not that the Swiss are taking an extreme right-wing position, but it does illustrate the point that in Switzerland, it's the people who are the final determinants of policy in all fields, and at any time, they can call for a referendum by petition, and that referendum will decide the issue. That's what we need in Australia, because in Australia, in recent years, we've had developed a duopoly of the two political parties. They are much more under the control of power brokers than they ever were. The power brokers are choosing candidates not on merit. They're choosing candidates because of their loyalty to the power brokers. And this duopoly would not be tolerated in any other comparable democracy. We need in Australia a system of direct democracy where the people decide who should be in parliament and do that regularly if they wish, where the people decide whether laws should continue and the people decide whether laws should be repealed. In other words, what they would do, what the people of Australia should be able to do, is to make the politicians accountable, not every 3 or 4 years in confected elections, but make them accountable on every day of every week, of every month, and of every year.